Welcome to WebSense Pro. Welcome to another video, and this time I'm creating a WordPress tutorial. So the reason why I'm creating that is the new year has started, and in 2024 many of the copyrights of your websites will go expire and you'll have to manually update all of them to 2024. And as an agency owner, I also faced that issue. But now you can use a small snippet of code and update that date automatically, so you won't have to manually update the date of your footer on all of the website if you're managing multiple websites like 20 or 100 websites. And if you want this only for Elementor, I already have created a video. You will find the link in the screen somewhere, and you can go to Elementor video if you are looking to update at dynamic date to your Elementor website. But this tutorial is I'm creating for WordPress. It's gonna work globally on all of the themes in WordPress and in all of the builders as well. So as you can see that on my screen, I have this WordPress install and I have copyright 2024, all rights are reserved. Now in this line, 2024 is a dynamic value which will auto update each year. So for example, if it's 2025, it will automatically update itself and you won't have to manually update that. Now I was going through a few websites on the internet, and they are really big media agencies, and I found some of the websites, they have that issue. So for example, this website I have in front of me, and if I scroll down, you can see that it's still saying 2023. Probably they don't have their date dynamically updating itself. Now we'll be following this code here. So all you have to do is just add a PHP code in your functions PHP. So that's the code which we will be adding in our functions.php and in child theme. Now, why we need to add it in child theme? Because if we add that code in parent theme and it updates like after a few weeks or a few months, this code will be removed and the updated code will be in the function.php. So this code will not exist, right? So we'll have to add that code in child theme, and I'm gonna walk you through how. So I have this WordPress install in order to show you guys. It's a test install, and I'm going to go to the dashboard, and here we will hover over appearance and go to theme file editor. Now I have Hello Elementor, which is a free theme, activated, and if I go to theme functions, functions.php, and scroll down to the bottom, I have this function added, which is creating a short code for me, which I have placed on my theme. So let me show you where I have placed the short code. So I'll click on edit with Elementor, go to Elementor backend, and that's the backend editor. Now, if I take short code widget, drag and drop it to my theme, and just place here, which is the short code for the current year. That's the function which we added in our functions.php here. So that's the code which we added in our functions.php, which is responsible to make this short code dynamic. So each time you add here, it will automatically update itself. Now the problem here is that we added this code in our parent theme, and as you can see, I have a theme update. And now if I update this theme, my function will be removed and my short code will stop working. So let me show you after updating the theme. If I click on update now, and now when I go back to the homepage of my website and hit refresh, you can see that the function which we created is no longer working, and now it's just showing the blank short code. In order to fix this issue, you will have to create a child theme, and it's super easy to create a child theme. We can simply Google child theme generator, and that's the website which will automatically generate our child theme. So we'll click on that, and we will click on this button called create a WordPress child theme now. Click on that. There are some ads, so I'm going to close it, and here we will add the name of a parent theme. So we will just copy it from themes. So that's a parent theme. Click on it and we will have our theme details. I'm just going to copy the name from our parent theme, paste it here. And for the slug of our parent theme, we will need to copy this from the URL. So after theme is equal to, we have the slug of our theme, which we will copy, paste it here. And we can name our child theme whatever we want. In this case, we can simply add hello Elementor child theme. Author, you can add your email address if you want to. I'm adding info@websensepro.com. Author, WebSensePro. And then I'll click on this create your child theme now button. And our child theme is good to go. Now all I have to do is just click on download your child theme now and our child theme will be ready. Okay, I have downloaded my child theme and now I'm going to upload it. Go back to themes, click on add new. And then click on upload theme. And then click on choose file. And then click on this latest.zip file which I have downloaded. And then click on install now. Okay, our child theme has been installed. Now I'm going to click on activate. And here we have our child theme ready to go. All we have to do is just go to theme file editor. Okay, so that's our functions.php file of our child theme. Now we will just copy this code, which is a function we created for the date. Just copy this code and paste it before the ending PHP tag. And then hit update file. And now let's go to home page and hit refresh to see our short code is updated or not. Now let's just hit refresh. And now you can see our copyright year will automatically update because of the function which we created. You can place this short code wherever you want. So let's go to edit with Elementor. And again, you can do that on any of the builder or any of the theme irrespective of Elementor. I'm just showing you in Elementor because I have that installed and I'm going to show that in the WordPress Gutenberg editor as well. So in Elementor, you can simply drag and drop the short code widget and add the short code year, which will display the current date as you can see. And now let's go back to our default WordPress editor. Let's click on pages and then click on add new. And that's our default WordPress editor. If you have any page created from the WordPress default editor, you can simply click on this plus icon and then search for short code. Click on short code and all you have to do is just add in the short code which we created and then hit enter. Sorry, just click anywhere else. And now it is responsible to display the current year date. Now if I publish this page and click on view page, you can see that it's displaying me the current year date and it's going to dynamically update itself when the new year comes in. That's it for the video, guys. Let me know in the comments below if you want more WordPress tutorials. I've been creating a lot of Shopify tutorials lately, but if you want more WordPress tutorial, let me know in the comments below. I would love to create more tutorials for you guys. Until next video, have a great day.